Hi, my name is Natasha Slayton, and I am a singer, songwriter, dancer, and a lot of other fun things. All that I ever needed was looking in the mirror back at me, and it's hard to believe that all of my life I couldn't see. Nobody could love me like, nobody could love me like me. Couldn't fix my pride. Yeah, so Love Me Like Me is the first official solo song that I've released, and I really wanted to create a song that could make a statement about everything that I've been through. I knew that, you know, since I've waited so long to create a solo song and to put something out of my own, that I really wanted it to be a testament to everything I've gone through and everything that I stand for. So this song, you know, as a reminder about all the dark times I've been through and how I've come out the other end, and all the work I've done on myself. And this song represents self-love and the ability to go within and heal ourselves. And it's a reminder that we have all the answers that we need inside of ourselves. So this song I started writing in 2019, and then I'm an independent artist, so I kind of work on things when I can, when the studio is available, when the producer is available. So when the pandemic hit, you know, everything obviously shut down, and production on the song shut down as well. But I think we finished it toward the end of 2020, maybe the beginning of 2021. And so, yeah, it just feels like the perfect time to release the song now that everything's starting to open up a little bit more. And yeah, the timing feels right. To the bottom, get straight to the point. If we got a problem, better make a choice. Get to the bottom, get straight to the point. Are we good? Are we good? Are we good? Are we good? Yeah, so with GRL, we still plan to move forward. We're trying to work on a reunion, but we've recorded a lot of songs that are ready to go, and we have a lot of other assets that we're sort of sitting on and waiting for the right time to release. This past year and a half or so, just, you know, it hasn't been easy for anybody, and GRL is definitely not exempt. And Emmeline is also in Canada for personal reasons, and Lauren has a baby that just turned 2 that she's, you know, really wanting to be present for. So we feel like there's a lot of challenges that have been sort of working against us at the current moment, and so we just sort of are waiting for the right time to, so that we can really put our heart and souls into everything GRL. Well, about, I don't know how long ago it was, but we started talking about doing a GRL reunion. It was actually Paula and Emmeline who had come to me and Lauren and were like, we really want to do a reunion. And so we were just like, yeah, why not? We started working, started recording songs, started getting together and like rehearsing some of our old dance routines. And Paula then decided, you know, she was like, oh my gosh, this was so much fun. Like, I really loved getting to see you guys again, getting to sing and dance with you guys, but this is just not where my life is heading. And I didn't know until now that this just doesn't feel right for me. So Paula exited the group, and it became the three of us, me, Lauren, and Emmeline. And so we just feel like there's so much unfinished business that we really want to continue with GRL. So I am working on a bunch of new music as fast as I possibly can as an independent artist with like zero to no budget. But I am working on new music. I'm continuing to do everything I can in terms of just continuing to create. So whether that means videos, photos, songs, whatever it is, I want to put it out for the fans. I want to put it out for myself. So yeah, I'm just continuing to create, and I don't plan to stop anytime soon.
Now, how is your music differently from the group, and how do you separate yourself from the two?
It's a really good question. I definitely feel like my music is still pop, just like GRL. The difference is that I get to write on all of the songs, of course. And with GRL, like when we first started, we didn't get to write on any of those songs. And then slowly but surely, we got to have a little bit more creative input along the way. But with my project, it's all straight from my soul, straight from my heart, everything that I've personally been through and want to speak about. So that's the difference for me. As an independent artist, I feel like social media is really one of the only ways that I have to market my music. The only real way that I have a connection to my fans is by getting on social media. So for me, it's extremely important to stay on social media. I love getting feedback. I love talking in the DMs and the comments, like wherever it is. I love connecting to fans because that's really what allows me to keep creating music and keep putting stuff out there. I do this because I love music. I feel like I've been through so much, from losing a band member and best friend to, you know, not long after losing my mom, and then going through severe addiction to drugs and alcohol, and you know, I've battled a lifelong illness and had a lot of health issues actually. And so to have gone through all of that and to be able to make music that says, you know, there is hope on the other side of that, to be able to share those messages, that's what truly matters to me. Because if I can, ooh, I'm getting emotional. If I can help or make a difference in even one person's life, like how cool is that? So that's really what matters the most to me. And I just have to keep going. You know, for me, there's no other option. I just have to keep going. So fans can follow me at Natasha Slayton on Instagram. And then for some reason, someone stole my name on Twitter and TikTok, somewhere in the mix of things. So on Twitter and TikTok, it's at Natasha Slayton, but at the end, it's two N's. So like Natasha Slayton. Stream Love Me Like Me out on all platforms, but especially Spotify, because that's what counts to the music industry right now. So yeah, thank you so much. Hi, my name is Natasha Slayton, and you've just been buzzed.